If you're a same-sex female couple that's trying to conceive, there are so many options that are available to you. It can be overwhelming. And if you don't know where to start, I can help you walk through every step of that process. So I think the first decision is, do we want to use a known sperm donor or do we want to use an anonymous sperm donor from a sperm bank? For most women, they will use an anonymous sperm donor. And so what we will do is we will actually give you a number of sperm banks that you can look at. You can definitely look at sperm banks even outside of the list that we give you, but we want to give you a starting off point. One thing that I think is really important to think about is how many children you want to have. And so if you said, you know, I want to have 2 children and I want to have 1 using my eggs, 1 using my partner's eggs, but we want to use the same sperm donor. A lot of the time I will encourage women to both get their testing done. So test ovarian function, test for genetic diseases, basically test everything that you need to so you can select a sperm donor that works for both of you. You're able to look through donor sperm profiles for all of the things that you would expect. Hair color, eye color, height, weight, background, ethnicity. You can look at all of those things. There are also gonna be a lot of things that you don't expect. You can, you know, pay a little bit extra if you wanna see a handwriting sample, if you wanna hear a voice sample. Definitely start taking a look at some of the donor sperm profiles. IUIs, or intrauterine insemination, are one of the simplest and kind of first line options for women who are trying to conceive with a sperm donor. So for a lot of my same-sex female couples that have no history of infertility, they have regular cycles, we will just have them track their ovulation at home with an ovulation predictor kit. And once they are getting ready to ovulate, we'll have them come in for an insemination procedure in the office. You will pick up your donor sperm vial from the sperm bank either the day before or the morning of, and they'll give you this lovely little liquid nitrogen container. We will then thaw the sperm, we will process it, we'll get it ready, and then we'll do the insemination. The insemination itself is really just like a speculum exam. It takes 2 minutes, if that. We just take a small, really flexible catheter and place it through the cervix into the uterus and drop the sperm off at the top of the uterus. Most women do not even feel a thing. If you feel anything, it's like a tiny cramp that lasts for 2 seconds and that's it. The other type of IUI cycle is a medicated IUI. For most young women who have no history of infertility and a same-sex couple, adding medication isn't always necessary because usually the chances of pregnancy are about the same. The times that it does make sense is if someone has really irregular cycles, someone who might have PCOS, or maybe someone that has lower ovarian function than we would expect. Sometimes we can consider giving women a little bit of oral medication or sometimes hormone injections to try to stimulate 2 or 3 eggs to grow and develop in a given cycle, because your body usually only makes 1 every month. But if we want to try to stimulate 2 or 3 to get a better chance of one of them giving us pregnancy, or if you don't ovulate and we just don't have an egg that releases on a predictable basis, then we can give you medications to help with that. For some patients who are 40 and older, or maybe have tried insemination and it hasn't worked, and sometimes they'll look at moving forward with IVF. With IVF, you take about 10 to 12 days of medication. It's usually fertility injections. They're small injections, kind of like a diabetic needle, really easy to give yourself. We'll show you how to do it. And when it looks like the majority of the eggs that are able to grow in that month grow and develop to the right size, we'll have you take a special shot to trigger their release and ovulation. And then we will have you come in 36 hours later for the egg retrieval. We will fertilize those eggs with our donor sperm, and then we'll see how many of those grow and develop into good quality embryos. We'll pick the best one and put it back. Let's say you just want to find a path that allows you to both really kind of participate equally. Co-IVF is a really unique and special thing that same-sex female couples have the opportunity to do. So if you were using your eggs, we would have you take medications to stimulate eggs to grow and develop, just like IVF, take the eggs out of the body, fertilize them outside of the body, and then see how they grow and develop. And then when we had a great quality embryo, we would place that embryo back into your partner's uterus. That allows your partner to carry the pregnancy and both of you to have kind of really unique, special ways of being a part of that pregnancy. Home insemination is an option for some patients. The chances are a little bit better if we're able to do insemination in the office, because I think one thing that we don't think about is when sperm are deposited in the vagina, either through intercourse or through a home insemination kit, only a fraction of them are making it into the cervix, and then a smaller fraction are making it into the uterus, and then a smaller fraction are making it into the tube. So if we can concentrate down the best ones and put them at the very top of the uterus so they're as close to the eggs as possible, that's gonna increase your chances. Plus, we have the ability to do those initial tests and tests to look at your ovarian function, tests to look at the tubes, because if there's something else that might be making it harder to get pregnant, I don't want you to spend 3 to 6 months and a lot of money on donor sperm to be doing that at home and then be unsuccessful because of something we could have found out from the very beginning. I would recommend reaching out to schedule an appointment with a specialist, you know, as soon as you're talking about building that family. If, you know, you are looking at getting started with the process and just want more information, I would say schedule an appointment. There's nothing to lose by scheduling an appointment. It doesn't mean that we absolutely need to move forward with some type of treatment right away. Or if you've tried a few cycles of home insemination and been unsuccessful, before you necessarily keep going down that path, I would recommend making an appointment pretty early on.